Hello friends, so here we go with the isometric projection. We'll take a simple problem where we can learn how to do a pentagon pyramid. Okay, so here we have a pentagon pyramid which is of 30 mm side and 60 mm resting on HP as a base side perpendicular to the VP. So draw the projection. So whenever we get any pentagon or a hexagon, first we need to construct a pentagon or a hexagon in a actual scale. Actual scale means using this. So we can take a 30 mm side. So you can take it as side here. Okay, so it's a 30. Okay, so not ISO, it's an actual scale. So next, what we'll do, we'll take a 72 degree. Okay, so from both the ends. Okay, so then taking the scale, we'll mark a 30. Then from both ends we'll cut the arc of 30. Okay. So we'll join the ends. So look at the center of this one. So 30 means it's a 15. Just drop a thin lines. So take any one end. Okay. So this is how exactly we need to construct a pentagon. Okay, so once you construct a pentagon, so we need to inscribe this pentagon in a rectangle, means we just extend the lines in such a way that so it will be placed inside a rectangle. So like this. Okay, so here we go with the one corner, second corner, third corner and fourth corner. Now you need to measure the distance. Okay, so from the corner to the corner. Okay, say from here to here, then here to here. Okay, so it is symmetric. So here this and this and this will remain same. So then we need to take a line from here to midpoint. And this will remain same. Okay, it is a symmetric. So if you measure any one, so it is coming around, so 25, you write 25 and 25. So from here to here it is coming 30, then 20. So you can write this is 30, this is 20. Okay, so once this one is done, similarly you can just take a line from corner to the end, 1. Okay, again same corner to the end. So this and this will remain same, and this already we know this is 30, this is a 30, and just measure how much you are going to get from here. Okay, it is coming around 7, and here also it is 7. So 7 and 7. Okay, so now if you just check out here, okay, so it will come. Okay, so now if you measure here, you're going to get 8 here and 8 here. So 30, 38, 46. So here we wrote 25 initially. You just check once again here, okay, properly. So it is coming around 23 and 23. So total it will be 46. Just check it out, like, because it is opposite one, so it will remain same. Okay, so if you have done anything wrong in that one, you just check it out. Okay, so this is how exactly we can mark. Okay, so what we did, we constructed one pentagon and inscribed one rectangle inside that one. Okay, so if you go like this, okay, you will get a rectangle inside that one. So one, this one is done, and this is a necessary one because this carries some marks. Okay, so one, that one is done. You just take any one reference point, usual one. Okay, so you will have one origin line here. Okay, a very thin. So take any one corner, say for example we'll start from here. Okay, so once we start from here, okay, so you need to refer to the lens from here. Okay, say for example, so once you move from here, this corner, so we'll take like this, like this, like this, like this. It's like anti-clockwise. Okay, so once we take a reference to the next corner, it is 30. So we'll take 1, 2, 3 here. Okay, so next it is a 20. So 1 and 2. Okay, that's the last dead end. Okay, next we need to move perpendicular. That is 23 and 23. So here it's a 23. Okay, so remaining it will be a 7. So 17, 17, 5, 22. So 23 around it will come here. Okay, so from here to here, then here to here. So 3 points, one end, so one center and one dead end. Okay, so again from here to here, so we have a 20 on the same line. So here we have a 20. Okay, so next it will be next end. Okay, so that is 30. So here to here 20, next 30, 1, 2 and 3. Okay, you can just check it out. It will come on a same line. Okay, so next we need to move 8. Okay, so from here it is like a 6, so total it will be 8 around, it will come here. Okay, from there, so 30, so 1, 2 and 3 here. Okay, so next it will be 8. Okay, so you have to come back to your point. Okay, so now you just need to say like here we have one corner, so one corner. So next on this line we have one more corner, one more corner. So again on this line we have one more corner. Okay, on this line we have a edge, so two corners, one here and one here. So now you just join only the pentagon. So we got a edge. Okay, so here we got a corner. Okay, so here also we got a corner. On this line we got a corner. Okay, so this is how exactly we can get the pentagon. Okay, so when the pentagon is done, okay, similarly, so we need to locate the center here. Okay, so to locate the center, so midpoint of this one, okay, so it will come here. Okay, so you just check it out. So from this corner, midpoint of the opposite line. Okay, so one line. So next you just measure any one line. So this is coming around 20, 28. So 14 is the midpoint and just drop a thin line. Okay, so we got a center here. Okay, here. So now the axis length of the pyramid, they are given it's a 60. So means you have to move vertically 60 mm. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and little bit 6 will get here. Okay, so now here to here you just draw one axis line like this. Okay, then to join the corners, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So these four are visible. So now this base is visible, this base is visible, make that dark, and this base is also visible. Okay, so now this slant edge is visible, dark. So this slant edge is visible, dark. So this slant edge is visible, dark, and this slant edge is visible, so dark. Okay, so through this one there is a slanted, but that is not visible, just dark. Make that one with the thin line. Okay, so this line is looking a little bit darker. You mark like this. Okay, so this is how exactly you can do the pentagon pyramid. Okay, so if it is a prism, okay, so if it is a prism, from each corner you take the eight and join. So we'll take that one in the next one. Okay, so just to have a recap, okay, what we did, whenever they give any pentagon or hexagon, you need to construct a pentagon with the actual scale, then you need to have a rectangle surrounding that one, and from each reference you just take the dimension like this. Okay, so from ear to ear, 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 then like this. Okay, and take any one corner as a reference. Say for example, I have taken ear, so that is a one reference, and move in a anti-clockwise direction, 30, 20, okay, then 90 degree turn, then 90 degree turn, then, so 30, 20, then 23, okay, next again 20, 30, next 8, 38, okay, so then drop the bisector, okay, just measure using the scale here itself and divide that one, okay, and take the midpoint and join it. From the center you take the height, that is they have given it's a 60, so then join to the corner, and when you see from here, so I can see the slant edge from here to here, here to here, here to here, here to here, and 1 and 2 and 3 edges, okay, so you make that one dark. So that is how exactly we can see the pentagon. Okay, so thank you.